Good evening, everyone. Carlton is sweating on the fitness of Matthew Kreuzer and Brock McLean for Saturday night's semi-final against the Swans in Sydney. The club's official line is both are expected to play, but Kreuzer could barely walk this morning while McLean had scans on his injured quad. Rob Waters begins our finals coverage.
It's as satisfying a win for Carlton since the 1999 preliminary final.
Hey, boys. Good morning.
Hey, Mick.
Chris Judd sauntered in after adding to his legend.
Yeah, no, definitely right. So, looking forward to be a great test for us.
Jared Waite recovered with the dog, Heath Scotland with the kids, and Nick Dygan could scarcely believe his luck, called up to play at the last possible minute.
I was only a couple of minutes away from heading up to the grandstand.
And what he was eating at the time is apparently important for the historical record.
I was actually just eating a sandwich from home, so I don't know whether...
Lucky to be there or not, Carlton has grabbed its chance.
We get enormous belief out of that, and I think we're slowly starting to get some respect, and it's all about going forward now and trying to get some respect off a great side in Sydney.
But Matthew Kreuzer limped into the club this morning and looked even worse when he left. The Blues are keeping the issue with Brock McLean in-house.
Brock was just a little bit tight and didn't want to risk himself going into the game and letting the team down, so it was a really good effort by him to say he wasn't right.
And Cade Simpson this week notches up his 200th match. The Swans face a big decision on Adam Goods, who's desperate to play but he's still well short of a gallop.
He'll be putting pressure on us, I'd imagine. Whether we pick him or not, I'm not too sure. And we'll sit down after he's trained this week both times and have a mature discussion about it and work out what we do with him.
Richmond's Rhys Conker spent Mad Monday getting his hamstring tested.
Yeah, it was pretty devastating, but, you know, we had a really good year and we'll build off that.
Rob Waters, 10 News.